Welcome. We are so glad you're here. My name is Cindy Carm, and I am president of the Board of Directors of the Fine Arts Chamber Players. We are just delighted to be here today. This is our second of seven of the Hallam Family Concert Series. It's part of our free concert series, including our basically Beethoven Festival Sundays in July at this space. I know some of you are familiar with that. And of course, this is possible because of the generous gifts of Fanchon and Howard Hallam, the City of Dallas Office of Arts and Culture, the Arts Community Alliance TACA, the Dallas Arts District Foundation, the Texas Commission on the Arts, and of course, the generous support of all of you. So if you are able and inspired, I will gleefully take your money out front. Or please visit us at our website, fineartschamberplayers.org, and there's a secure link that you can support our mission to provide free concerts and free education to school children here in the Dallas area. So if you haven't already, please take this opportunity to silence your cell phones. And also, if anyone needs to step outside, they will broadcast the music out front. So if you have young ones that are restless, or you get restless, then you're welcome to just step outside for a moment. We are very thrilled to have you here today. And without further ado, please welcome the Cézanne Quartet.
Thank you. thank you all so much for joining us at Moody Performance Hall. We have a delightful program in store. And the theme of today's program, if you look at your program book, is the sacred and the profane. And we're exploring ancient influences and how they impact much more modern writing for chamber music. So that was Debussy's Danses sacrée et profane. Yes, that's where I got the program title. One of the most important works for the harp. It was written right around the time that this instrument was being created for the first time, and it ushered in a new era of repertoire for us and opportunities as well. And the next piece is based on the myth of Theseus and the Minotaur. And to talk about it, I am very delighted that my wonderful friend now and colleague, Michael Ippolito, has come up from San Marcos. He is the composer of the next piece and also the pianist for William Grant Still's Ennanga. So please welcome Michael.
So I'm particularly pleased to bring Mythos here to Dallas because in a very real way, it was born out of my experience in Dallas in 2019 when the DSO played one of my orchestra pieces. And the orchestra, as you all know, is excellent. But even in the excellent orchestra, the harp playing stuck out to me and I thought, oh, I've got to meet the harpist. And we started chatting about maybe doing a project together, and I'm really glad that it came to creating this piece, and Emily just does an incredible job. She should get some credit as a co-composer, I think, just for her harp-specific knowledge that really made this piece come to life. As she said, it's about the myth of Theseus and the Minotaur, but specifically, I was interested in this short story by Borges, the Argentinian writer, called La Casa de Asterion, which is the House of Asterion, one of the family names that has been associated with the Minotaur. And it tells the story from the monster's point of view, which I found kind of eerie. And I kind of converted that story into a three-movement piece for harp. The first is a prologue, just like ancient Greek storytellers might be telling the story with a harp and sing as well as tell the story. This is kind of setting the scene and introducing the characters. The middle movement is structured actually based on the shape of the labyrinth. So I took graph paper and really measured out the proportions of each turn. And so you'll hear anytime that there's a rhythmic change or a harmonic change, it's sort of like you've made a turn as you're running through the labyrinth from a Theseus point of view. At the very end of that movement, you can't miss it. There's a swipe as Theseus delivers the killing blow to the Minotaur. And then the final movement is really where we get the Minotaur's perspective, and I think of it as a sort of death song of the Minotaur, where we get to kind of get the story from the Minotaur's perspective as a misunderstood maybe creature. So with that, I'll turn it over to Emily. Thank you. Thank you.
We have one more piece for you by the American composer William Grant Still, and it's called Ennanga, which is an ancient African harp. And this piece was new to me until, well, here's a story for you, but the DSO was going to perform the first movement, and it happened to be the same weekend as my husband's doctoral graduation and my best friend's wedding. So I did not play with the DSO, but then I was like, I want to learn this piece. And now here we are. This piece is just wonderful. It's, for me, it captures the essence of American music. There's classical elements, there are jazz elements, there's spiritual elements, there's that Americana folk sound, but it's really, really stunning. The outer movements are energetic, playful, with a singing melody that goes on top, and the middle movement is kind of a static reflection on the chord A minor, with a little bit of variety in there, but it's very meditative and very introspective and reflective. So I just wanted to say thank you to you all for coming today. We've had so much fun putting this concert together, and I hope you enjoy Ennanga. Thank you.